I don't know which story. Just watching the video, we've spent a lot of time there, obviously. So many things, like so many people in this room. I was actually out in earlier today and drove by the old Sharps dress shop, and when we were just talking about a little child as children running around and playing in the dress shop, and there were a few funny instances that I remember. For some reason, they always involve the bathroom. I'm not really sure. And you know, we had the years at Nana's, had a few times. The family reunions with the kids, trips to Florida, trips everywhere. In fact, this has been kind of. She's taken a lot of time to visit a lot of people in this room over the last few years, in particular myself. And some of the best memories I have recently was her traveling out to Arizona, we went to the Grand Canyon. Didn't have a plan, it was very spontaneous. And the amount of time you're able to spend together when you don't have a plan is amazing. And it turns out good because there's no expectation. So, and meeting Bill, she told me he was tall. I'm very short. So tall to me is enough to speak. So, yeah, and I'm wearing 5-inch heels.
Wow. I think it's a big secret that maybe wanted to be in the seminary. It's got to be true. Because he is so full of faith and so full of love. And from talking with his parents, I have found also that he has an issue owning things. So I hope to send them away with the idea that to be real careful about what you purchase, the next time you get it, you're going to have to pay for it yourself. But anyway, I love you both. I'm glad I didn't have to send the seminary exit. And I just couldn't be prouder.
Shorter, older brother. My man's 6'6". Should have eaten a few more vegetables when I was a child. But Phil and I actually go way back. You know, we were best buddies when we were younger. Always hanging out, having a good time in the backyard. Parents were pretty limited on the TV and kind of other media watching. So we spent our good days hanging out in the sand baths and running around the backyard and having a good time playing sports. You know, life was so good back then. When I was 4 or 5, and I think maybe Phil was 2 or 3, we came to my mom and we said that we had decided we were going to get married. Because we were having such a good time, and we knew married people got to spend the rest of their lives together. We said, this sounds great. We run around the backyard and dig in the sandbox all the days of our lives. What more could it possibly be? Well, needless to say, Phil grew up, and if you stood next to him, he really grew up. Quite a ways. And Phil, it's just been great to see you mature and grow into a great man of God, a good brother, and a good friend. I've really enjoyed, especially watching you make the Lord the Lord's name of your life. You're really choosing to be a Christian and choosing to be a disciple of the Lord and make that kind of key thing that you're looking to do in your life. I've really enjoyed watching that, seen it happen over the last couple of years. So you've kind of matured through college and gone to graduate school. I've always enjoyed our conversations, hanging out, talking about whatever in life. And those are the times I think I'll remember the most. Just hanging out and chatting about all kinds of things in life, talking on the phone. Something that I really appreciate about you. You go deep, your faith goes deep. You see truth and you cling to it. And you call others into that. I think that's great. And I think your friends appreciate it too. You know, we were getting together, all the groomsmen, and talking a couple days ago. And it's really good to see how loyal of friends you are. A lot of these friends go way back. You're a committed brother. Talk on the phone all the time to them, talk on the phone all the time to your family. You're committed and you're loyal. I think that's really important. I know a lot of the guys that go back a long ways know that if anything ever happened to them, if they were in a time of need, if something happened where they needed a friend, that you would be in their corner no matter what. You're the kind of friend and the kind of brother that someone can rely on when they're in need. I think that's really an awesome characteristic. Finally, the thing that I've really enjoyed about you also is that you're just a lot of fun to be around. Spontaneous. You know, times have changed when we used to hang out in the backyard and hit apples from the neighbor's yard with golf clubs. I think they probably call the police on us nowadays if we did that. But you're a great guy to be around. Just whether it's Friday night or whether it's Tuesday evening and it's raining and there's nothing to do but hang out and play cards, you're a great guy to be around. You're just fun to talk to and you're always up for doing something, whether it's a road trip or just hanging out and chatting or doing the barbecue. You're just always up and having fun and hanging out. That's great. As I was kind of thinking about all the places you've gone and where you've come, I was reflecting a little bit on how Phil got down to Texas. You know, we're from Michigan, and Texas is a long ways away. And I was just reflecting back on when you decided to go to grad school and you made it down to Texas. Texas was so warm and beautiful and loving. I think there was something in the air where we talked a few months after you've been down there, and you were like, you know what? I've decided it's time for me to find a wife. And, like, all right. So, he got to it, you know, the same way Bill gets to a lot of things he chooses to do. Got to work, might read a couple books, did some online research. Compared to this, the characteristics he was looking for. Probably ran a few statistical analyses. And he found the list. And, you know, that's awesome. You know, Melissa, we weren't really quite sure what we thought of you being King of Michigan. You know, we weren't exactly sure. We saw a lot of pictures, Phil doing some funny things, and we're like, who is this girl? And we finally came to Michigan, and we realized that Melissa is awesome. You're just great. And, she and Phil came over to my house for dinner a couple of months ago. I think you guys had already been engaged, and you were in town. I live with a couple other guys. We share a house together. We had dinner, and my roommates were like floored by Melissa. They were like, this is the most impressive woman we have ever met. In fact, they still talk about her every once in a while. When the wedding invitation came, they were really disappointed that it only had my name on it. So Melissa, you're making quite a fan club there back in Michigan. And I think that's good. I think it's important. When I look at your guys getting married, what that's going to mean for the world, I think your marriage is going to have a huge impact on people. You know, part of it is because you've got so much energy, so much enthusiasm for life. You're out to take over the world and take it by storm. And I think that's just going to have a huge impact on people. But also, the way that you care for each other, the way that you love each other, the way that you love your friends, I think that's going to be a huge witness to people. And I think, furthermore, what's really at the source of all that is the fact that the Lord is at the center of both your lives. That your marriage is really about Him, and that you see that, and you know that that's really what you're pursuing and what you're shooting for. And so, if I could maybe leave you with just one thing, maybe a request, as you're here getting married, first, I want to kind of jump in and make a request before all the rest of you guys kind of get to it. And that is, be open with your life. Share it with others. Be quick to make friends, invite people over, let them see the life that you're going to have together. Because I think it's going to be a huge witness to others. And this world is in great need of heroes. Not the kind of heroes you see on TV, but the kind of heroes that you hang out with and have dinner with and go over to the house and share life together. I think you guys are really going to be that for a lot of people. So I just encourage you to be open with your life, to share it with others. Will be a huge witness, and I think the Lord has got great plans for you guys. I know He will bless your life. I know He's got a tremendous plan for what He has in store for you. So, if you'll raise your glass with me, toast to. Waiting for Phil to get a glass. Oh, you got there. All right, so to Bill and Melissa, may the Lord bless you, may you increase your love for each other, may you be joyful and happy all the days of your life today.
Even though I believe that Phil and Melissa
have the most beautiful souls that anyone could have created. I do think that they will continue to grow together and build on the beauty that everyone already sees in them. I wish you best of both in your future and faith and love. Danil and Melissa Gatt.
Industry, get back on their feet, learn trade skills, get counseling, things like that. So So on behalf of all of you, we have made donations to those three organizations as a gift to each of you this evening. So just wanted to share that with you. So with that, please enjoy dessert. And around 11 o'clock, we're actually going to be making our exit. So they'll let you know when we're going to be gathering outside. Thanks so much.
They're not going to make it down the street. Yeah.